he's at least 200 years ahead in the future. He claims that his knowledge comes from the chip that was implanted in his head from his abduction. And definitely, if you start looking at Palafoli's artwork, you'll see that he is just way ahead of his time. He designs machines that incorporate 1,000-foot genetically modified jellyfish as their power source.
Really?
Yeah.
I mean, I've seen a few of his artworks, and they're just amazing and beautiful, but I haven't had time yet to study all of his blueprints, basically. I have a whole database on one of his website, basically, with tons of this stuff. You know, he's amazing, that's for sure.
Yeah, he gave us a four-hour lecture, and then I talked with him for another 2.5 hours after that.
Mm-hmm.
So I have a good 6.5 hours of Palafoli discussing all these things.
Wow, that's amazing. Hey, Freeman,
he is a magician. He is a Kabbalist, you know, and I don't ever mean this in a negative fashion. You know, there's good Kabbalists, bad Kabbalists, right?
Mm-hmm, yeah.
But the point being that he is a Kabbalist, and he was hired as such to design a Kabbalistic garden. He's working on one of his own right now, and incorporating geomancy or earth magic into the structures.
Hmm.
Now, here is a man that is into creating symbolic architecture that, you know, supposedly has effect, and he was hired on as one of the World Trade Center or the Twin Towers architects.
Yeah.
And was actually fired from being such because he suggested they put these passageways between the Twin Towers and was fired on the spot for even suggesting such a thing because they wanted to keep this within their Masonic symbolism of the twin columns of Jachin and Boaz. So right then and there, you've got an alchemical building being created by a Kabbalist. You know, there's just no doubts in this anymore.
Yeah.
That this was a symbol of the Illuminati.
Amazing. And again, I think he did an interview on Radio Orbit. This was a while back when he talked about that they actually built in even explosions in the World Trade Center buildings, I think.
I hadn't heard that.
Okay, you guys didn't talk about that at all?
No. Oh. See, I didn't know any of this stuff about Paul until we started talking.
Okay. Hmm.
So.
Yeah, I have to send you that clip. I think it's still available either on Mike Hagan's website or somewhere on the web. I got to find that for you, and I can link that up to this interview also. That's an interesting, clip in itself. But, you know, Freeman, I have to actually suggest that we begin to round things off for this segment because we're beginning to run out of time for this first segment. We're definitely going to continue talking more here. We have tons of stuff that we haven't gotten to yet. The Knights Templar, the 700-year anniversary. We've got to talk about your UFO sighting. I mean, there's tons more here. But I know that you specifically wanted to kind of round things off on a synchronistic note, so to speak. You want to talk a little bit about kind of the background story or the basic message behind what you have been experiencing so far, isn't that right?
Absolutely, because really, once I present all this information, the likely and the most common question that comes my way is, well, what do we do? And I really do believe that the answer is in the story. And it's not in the details, not in the facts that are given, not in the fact that there's Kabbalists creating geomantic structures around the globe, but in the fact that God, or the universe, however you want to call it, the Most High, that there is an oversoul, that there is a power that can guide you, and that this is the true answer, that identifying the enemy and eradicating him is not our answer. This one has never worked. But as we start to move into this closing years up to 2012, we start to move more and more into the Mayan mindset, which is based on synchronicity. And with all of their calendars, I think they had over a dozen calendars, they were designed in order to keep them within the synchronistic realms. And we ourselves we can highlight one or two. You know, we get goosebumps or whatever when we find ourselves in a perfect situation. And for the Mayans, this seems to have been their natural state. And I believe we're moving into that type of mindset and that these synchronistic events are occurring more and more. So for me to have all of these inner links, you know, as we've covered with sitting at Athena's restaurant. These, to me, are the true story, that the miracle of life that has been forgotten, the wonder. Everybody wants to believe at this point that they know everything and there is no sense of wonder left in humanity. And if that's the case, we're all doomed. That's not the case.
Yeah, exactly. That's not the case. You're absolutely right. I couldn't agree more. And again, I think that your, I think that your work is so you know, wonderful in that way. I remember the first DVD that I watched that you did. I think it was called just The Freeman Perspective, basically. And that to me had that kind of quality and that kind of sense to it. The mystical aspects and the enigma was still there in a way. This was not just all about revealing how, you know, how planned everything is in advance and that we basically have no chance here. This is about, you know, also finding the mystical aspect in all this. And I think that you are able to portray that beautifully, Freeman.
Yes, that is the main underlying theme of Freeman. My life is just too miraculous, and I don't think it's just believe me. I don't think that, you know, I'm some special being that gets guided. I think it's all of us. But once you release your control dramas, once you release your boundaries, you know, I drove to Portland, Oregon with -$6 in my bank account. I'm not stopped by rational thinking, you know. I have absolute faith in this miraculous world, and I live by it. And that is my true message to the world. All the rest is just fluff, really, and interesting. And I only want to spread wonder. I don't want to give people a message of who to hate and who not to hate. You really can't use me for that. I'm way out there, you know. People that want to create a rigid belief system can't use me. But that is it. That really is the guiding factor, is open yourself up to this synchronistic, mystical, miraculous realm and just watch as it unfolds. It doesn't require your planning. It doesn't require you to outline it. It will outline itself and will be even more spectacular and miraculous than you could have outlined for yourself.
And that's why you need to head over to freemantv.com and check out some of Freeman's material that he has on there. Tell us about some of the DVDs that you have there before we round things up here.
Okay, well, I have the 3-hour The Freeman Perspective, which is my first and still my favorite, which goes into all things from Masonic symbolism and corporate logos to harp and chemtrails. I get an hour on the goddess Columbia, and I think I'm the only authority on Columbia. I'm the only one I can find. Just who she is, what she might symbolize, and then finally I wrap that all up with a tale of synchronicity and how I feel that this all works and how miraculous and wonderful our lives really are, even when we're staring down this gun.
That's right.
And then I have the Return of the Nephilim, which is 5 hours with Michael Tsarian, Giorgio Tsoukalos of the Ancient Astronauts Research Center. I speak with Aurelian, which I got into with Paul Affoli a little bit, and then, of course, my hour presentation on the fact that civilization on planet Earth goes back much, much farther than people are willing to accept and has reached a high state of technological advancement in the ancient past. So that's Return of the Nephilim. And then I've released Anna Nicole Brittany and Mind Control, which is just an unbelievable tale and has continued to this day. Brittany's bodyguard came out and said that Brittany was speaking in strange languages and that it actually frightened him. And she's now being sent back to the Crossroads Clinic where this whole story began. And then in that, you'll see some things that'll just blow your mind about mind control. You'll see our president, or President Clinton, in a mind control state, and just things that you're not, you know, many people aren't ready to accept. And finally, oh, I know I have one more. Oh, Codex Magica with Tex Mars. Now that's story fits into this story, and we'll get into that next. But the hand signs and gestures of the Illuminati, 2 hours with the evangelist Tex Mars.
Excellent. So, exactly. And again, the website is freemantv.com. And again, if we have any listeners down there in Austin listening, your TV show later tonight, tell us how they can tune into that.
It is Thursdays at 10 p.m. Central Standard Time, and it's on Channel 16. We have a really good lineup on ACTV this year. It's a good time to have access television.
Sounds good. Excellent. I and Freeman, or me and Freeman, are going to continue talking more in the subscriber section. And as I said, we have lots more good stuff to get to. We're going to talk about the UFO sighting and the Templars, the 700th anniversary coming up here. What is it, tomorrow? No, on Saturday. That's right. Lots more good stuff coming up. But for this segment, Freeman, thank you so much for coming on.
Hey, thank you, Henry.